Hello, everybody. Today I'm going to be doing, I already had this tutorial in Spanish. I'm going to do this one in English. I'm going to do an alien. I believe I'm going to do a different one. I'm going to try to do this one over here. It's a Coast Baby version of the alien, and it's a fusion of the Predator and alien. And I had a lot of fun doing the other one, so that's why I decided to do this one too. So, starting, we're gonna start ZBrush, this tutorial, and then it's for medium users. It's not that complicated. Comma, to take that away. C-sphere, we drag it in the middle with shift to make it center. Then we press T, X to have the symmetrical choice on. I press the brackets to make the brush bigger or smaller. The brackets next to P, the letter P on your keyboard. Then I'm gonna press Q to draw and make the first, make the head. Let's try it. Let's see how it is. E to scale it the way we want it. I'm gonna try to beat a record here. I'm gonna try to make it in less time than the time that I did the other one. Probably I'm gonna do different approaches too. And let's do Q because we were on moving. This is gonna be a neck, the body. W. E. Let's make this a little bit more like that. And we have for the reference, I went to internet. I look for aliens, Coast Baby. I downloaded a couple pictures that I liked and some references. For example, I cannot see here pretty well. A lot of things that I can see in this one over here. It gives me a better idea what they were thinking when they were doing it, you know. So it gives me a better understanding of what I want to do, how I want to do it. So for this, let's see how they want it. E, let's make this a little bit bigger. W, let's put it a little bit more like that. Q, let's make the arms. 1, 2, 3. W, let's move around, scale that one. E with E. W, let's move it. W, let's move this one. This is a funny one. I like these kind of tutorials. It's a lot of fun making these ones. And Q, let's make the fit. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. There you go. W. I'm gonna scale that one a little bit. The brush size, like, smaller. Remember, you can do with your creation. You want the way you want it, you know. If you want to do a realistic one, a comic one, whatever, let me see your approaches. I'm very, very happy to see things that people may do with my ideas, you know. And let's do this one a little bit, finger in the back. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Let's move this one. You see, when you see a ghosting over here, it's because there's something weird happening. See? You better don't let this happen. That means you did something that is gonna be affecting the mesh. So I just saw it. So Q, Alt. I press Alt to delete this, and then W to set it up the way it's supposed to be set it up. because I had selected this sphere over here when I was drawing the other one. It just went from the... It went from this side all the way to the front. So, just to be sure, I'm gonna make it again. You know, W, let me move it. Q. Finger. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Control C. I did something weird over there. No worries. 1, 2, 3. Now we can control C. I don't know what was that. Now I can see the floor. I just activate the floor. Let's see. I want to put this aligned with the floor, so I'm going to move it around. I'm going to move it around. Okay. Let's see. I'm moving to move around with my camera. It's just like, it's very easy. The left click of the mouse, any part around the canvas, not on the model, just click it and drag it. There you go. F is to see the whole model. Okay, so let's make the fingers now here. We press Q, just to make sure that we're editing right now. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. E, to scale it. This one doesn't seem to be pretty uniform, this one either. Actually, it kind of looks weird. Let me rotate it. I just click the sphere and click R to rotate the hand the way I want it. There you go. So this one I like how it was like broken. W, let me set it up the way I want it. There you go. With W. I remember it's a monster, but let's try to make it. Q, Alt, let's delete that one. W, E, let's scale this a little bit less, this one too. W, move it around. And we're gonna continue this on the model once we finish. Now we're gonna go get the tail. Are we in the back or the front? There you go. Yeah, we're right. Q, if you don't see the green dot, it's because you're in moving or rotation, whatever it is. Press Q, and then you know that it's on the... It's working. And remember, I do the C spheres. I work with them like in this way because if I don't turn the symmetry on, sometimes I have trouble because the body doesn't go all the way down in a symmetrical way, and maybe the spine could be like moved a little bit to the left. So when I'm sculpting, then I'm gonna have like my cursor in one part of the sculpting, like sculpting nothing, you know. So that's why I turn it like that. Q, Alt. I'm gonna delete this one. I'm gonna make it easier. W. I should have done just this when I started to have it uniform, kind of the tail. Okay. So now that you have the three segments, now you press. You already are in the mode of drawing, you just press in between. 1, 2, 1, 2. Maybe one there. W. And then you just move it. You just kind of make a nice and a smooth way the tail is just positioning right now. Okay, it's good enough. F is good enough to start. Okay, so remember to save every time. I just save it. Cosbaby AVP Predator Cosbaby 1. Okay, that's done. Brush, let's turn that off. Let's make the skin preview. A little bit more density, like 4 preview. Make it. There you go. Now that we make it, let's make a. We could start doing something over here, but I'm gonna jump in right now into the skin. So I have the skin over here, or I can tell you what I did in the other one. Let's do it. I don't want to be doing something different in each tutorial. So for this one, the other thing that I did, I just press Shift A. And this says C sketch mode. And for C sketch mode, Q, when you press Q, okay, look at this. I used to do the brush like in a size like a 9 or an 8. And then you start sculpting. Sculpting the things you think is going to be for your alien, like if you see this kind of stuff comes all the way over here, and then 1, 2, 3, and then we can go over here, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and then we have something going over here like this, something like this. Can change the size too much. Control C. Control C. The arms, look at that. Something. It's gonna be hard to do it in this kind of. We are gonna try to do something quick. Remember, you can pass as much time as you want with your model. It's your creation. I'm just going to try to do it faster. I'm going to show you the ways you can be making this. Just kind of trying to do stuff that might look like that, you know. It's just a baby. This is gonna be cool. Now the neck, let's try to do something over there. Did you see we make something over here? Alt, we take it off. Take it off, there you go. It was from the neck. Now we can go smaller again. We can even delete it, but the neck, let's do this tubing, 1, 2, 3, 4, small ones, 1, 2, 3, 4, maybe we can start doing like the S shape, defining the middle of the face. And then after here, we're gonna make the mouth. So now we have, now that we have that, it's like a, it's like a guide, you know. Okay, something like that. You can smooth out with Shift. and you can move around with W. If you didn't want a shape to be like two out, you can move it around. There you go. You want something more like out. There you go. And now we are gonna make this a little bit more like this. Control C, Control C, Control C. It was better like that. Once we have it, we're gonna modify it. Now we're gonna press, instead of a sketch, Q. We were in moving armature. We're gonna make the two little horns that come from the back or spine kind of stuff. Okay, so Control C is too big. One, two. There you go. F. So now that we have that, we're gonna go to Unify Skin Preview. It's to pixelated division 2. Smooth 0, let's see how it goes. Nope. Smooth 49. Kind of. Yeah, it's good to start. Why not? Let's see. Although, it looks kind of weird in a way, don't you think? Let's see it in the... There you go. Could work. Okay. Make it. Make a unified skin, and it's done. Now we're gonna select the skin that we have over here. And we're gonna append the other one. Append. There you go. Now we're gonna see this one is 132, this one is 16. We're gonna merge those ones together. So merge down. Okay, there you go. And you're gonna see the polyframe is not helping. For fixing that, what I do, I come over here, Dynamesh 512. We do it, yeah, we say no to what it said over there. We don't want to keep the divisions and stuff. So once it's doing all that over there, we go to polyframe, way better for sculpting. Okay, so now I'm gonna make a deformation polish. There you go. And I'm gonna move a little bit of stuff around. This was just kind of like pointing out what I wanted. X, move. Move. Just refining this. Smoothing out, smooth with shift. And remember, if something doesn't come the way you want, you can go back always. So I'm gonna go back over here to the original one. I'm gonna go to C sketch, edit, show, and then see how it comes this way. This way it looks a little bit better or not? What do you think? Density 2, density 4, 6. This one is a little bit better, so I'm gonna make it. And I'm gonna go and this one, is this one over here. Sub tool. And if you see, this one over here is 1.7 million, so that's too much. So I'm gonna, for this, I'm gonna just, take away these ones over here. And these ones over here, refine it with shift. And what I'm gonna do first, move and move this a little bit like this, smooth this out. Alt floor, we don't need it right now anymore. So what I'm gonna do right now to take this down, let me see the polyframe. The polyframe is not that good too for, it's good for editing. We can start editing this, so we can go like move around right now, move around the way we want the shapes, you know, smooth that with shift. I use it the brush a little bit longer, bigger I mean. It's supposed to be the mouth. We're gonna make it more threatening. Down. Remember, each one is supposed to be different. It's your style. And the one that we were trying to do is supposed to be this one over here. Have to keep in mind that. 1, 2, 3, 4. Wow, that's a lot of work, but let's try to do it. I believe something went wrong when the machine was doing the, look at the fingers, how they go all the way back. But I like overall the shape of the alien. For that I can go like a control shift and select lasso or control and mask it, mask rectangle, this one over here. I'm gonna make this group mask, and then once this group, control shift, now they are gone. Now I'm gonna say for this, control alt, control A, let's see if that works. Now it was mask geometry, topology, polygroups, let me see, group visible, we don't see it over here, we cannot split the hidden ones, should be under sub tool, split, glue, no, we don't have that option right now. So anyways, for this, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to, first, I'm going to go to the decimation master. This is too much. Decimation of 50%, probably 33. Pre-process the current. Oh, this is not a polymesh 3D, so make a polymesh 3D. So now it is a polymesh 3D. Now that is a polymesh 3D, now I'm going to be able to do that I was trying to do, because control shift, select this one again, so I'm going to delete the hidden one and then close the holes. Now that's way better. Now we can use the insert mesh. We're going to press B, I, and then we're going to O, and then M. And then we're gonna choose a hand. We're gonna choose a hand that looks, we can make it like an alien hand, probably this one. You always start with the left side, then we drag it from here. There you go. Then we situate it, W. There you go. We can scale it to E. looks good to me. Control C, Control C, Control C, Q. I didn't have symmetry on, so I'm gonna put it now. So now again, M. We choose this one with three fingers. 1, 2, 3. Now W. There you go, there you go. Looks good. F, we check that. Maybe the size a little bit smaller. W, we move this again. Okay, 1, 2. Okay, Control A, there you go. Clear the mask. Q. Okay, now let's get ready. Plug in, how many million? 1.46. Decimation master at 33%, pre-process the current one. Analyzing the mesh. I should have saved before doing this, but my computer is doing fine so far, so I don't think it's gonna crash. But you always try to save. It's never too much to save, like 3-4 times in a project like this. So reordering, check this number over here, 1.46. the less, the more RAM is gonna be like available for you, and you're gonna be doing everything more smooth. Okay, supposed to be done already, or it was the pre-process. It was the pre-process. Now we go again and we decimate it. And then again, I should have saved. Now I'm afraid something's happening. Look at this. Please don't crash on me. Don't crash on me. Don't crash on me. Your ZBrush makes a quick save if you, something like this happen. I don't think it's gonna happen here, but let's see what happens. It took already too long. So ESC. There you go. 4094. So now we're good. Save it. There you go. We're saved. Geometry. Now I'm gonna go to Dynamesh 512 and Dynamesh it. Projection in progress. There you go. Polyframe, way better. Okay, now we're gonna, I don't like when it's moving like that, so F, there you go, way better. To keep it in the center, I just choose local, like that, and then I'm gonna use brush, standard, and then Alt, I mean Control, then I'm gonna go mask, pen. And then we're gonna do it. We're gonna trace the mouth. Control outside to make an inverse mask. Check if we don't have another mask. No, there you go. That's the only one. That's good. W. We do the angle with the angle that we want to put the mouth inside. There you go. F. There you go. Control A. Now let's see. 1, 2, 3. Now we are gonna use Q and then move. Brackets. I'm gonna make it a little bit bigger over here. More menacing. Remember, it's your creation. You can do with your creation whatever you want. You can do make it look the way you want it. It can have a belly, can be skinny, can be whatever. Here we have to make a little bit of adjustments. For this one, shift. Maybe we can do something over here, I don't know, so it doesn't look like that. We're gonna close holes. Maybe we can make a trim. Control C. It was too harsh. Maybe we're gonna do clay tubes with the intensity of 12 with Alt. And then we can sculpt on top. Let's see. Clay tubes. And I'm dealing with the head and everything, so it's better to go F. Control Shift Select Lasso Control C Control. There you go. Way better. Move. Besides, it's an alien, right? Let's see if local is gonna fix this kind of weird issues we're having when we're moving this around. Smoothing this out. Clay tubes with intensity a little bit 28. Of a skeletal structure. It's a toy anyways, but a pinch to make the fingers. Control C. It was too far away. Now let's do it again. There you go. F. Control Shift outside. F. There you go. Okay, so now we're gonna start doing the sets of the face. I don't want it to be this kind of a diamond shape, so I'm gonna use move. Remember, I have this over here. My brushes, I have it custom brushes in the way I use it, so if I use it too much, I just put it right away there. And pretty much the ones that I use the most is move, trim dynamic, clay pinch, inflate damon standard. It's a pretty cool one too. And then we smooth it with the algorithm of a ZBrush. Okay, and for this one, I'm gonna move this one a little bit to the side. There you go. So when we look at from the side, it looks like that too. It doesn't look weird. Well, it has to look weird. It's an alien, right? There you go. The mouth in the menacing way. Threatening, right? Now it looks like it's smiling. There you go. Now it looks like it's mad. Remember, everybody has different approaches, different styles. You're welcome to try yours. Okay, now to make these ones over here, we're gonna use the snake hook intensity, probably like it's Dynamesh, so don't worry about the pixelation of the clay. So I'm gonna move it. I'm gonna go like this, Control C. Intensity 100. So I'm gonna isolate the face. I don't wanna do something weird. Control Shift. There you go. And I'm going to isolate just the frontal part. Control Shift. There you go. So this one I'm gonna get it from down, a little bit smaller. Okay. Now we move it around. And you're gonna see polyframing. That here we have like a stretch polygons, but it is Dynamesh. Control Shift. So the moment we do this, Control, and we drag a mask outside, it's gonna fix everything like that. If you see kind of something weird over there, now it's gonna be all proportional and ready to redefine. See? So all we have to do now is smooth it out. And we can keep continue. Control C. I wanted to smooth that with the shift. There you go. Now we can be making like a building stuff over here. Maybe we can make a inflate over here to put here the thing. Inflate it. Intensity 10 right now. Okay. Inflate that. There you go. And you're gonna say it's looking weird. Yeah, it's looking weird and pixelated. Now mask. Now it's good to go. Now we're gonna make the holes over there with the standard brush where the fangs are gonna go. Control C for make a hole. We press Alt. Then we're gonna put the fangs over there. Alt. Looks more like that, so we can move it. We can move around whatever we want, so don't worry. Actually, what we can do too, if you wanna, here, Control, and we have mask. We can mask lasso, and select these ones, and then invert it. There you go. Now we can go W, click it, rotation. There you go. Easy, right? There you go. We can go rotation like this. There you go. What do you think? I believe it was too much like that, so maybe like that. There you go. Control A, Control. Now we're gonna do the same with the lower one. We just have to find the, there you go, Q. If we don't see a prior Q, now we have the mask. Let's do it again. Mask, inverse, Control, outside. Now we're gonna go W, rotation, a little bit up in these ones over here. Rotation. It was not properly aligned. Rotation. And we can move it too with W. Rotation. Okay, Control A. There you go. We can fix that. We can just Q, Shift, and then we can put like tubes over there. There you go. It's an alien. It's a monster. So it's organic. So don't worry. He'll be fine. F. Okay, now let's save. Remember to save. 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 Yes. So he has a frontal thing, and then 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And then, like, kind of a brain over there. Wow, it's weird. Weird. Clay tubes. We can change the material. I like a comic lizard. Control C. I just did a mistake over there. So, 1, 2. Control C, C. Control C. Maybe this one's a little bit over here. This one's a little bit over here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Another one before, I believe. There you go. And we have one like this. One like this. And then here we have like diamond shape. Then it shows the brain. It has stuff coming over here. I don't know what's gonna be over there. We don't have a sample. We're gonna have to think about it, what to do. Gonna make a small one over here. He has some stuff coming over here. Over here. We can make negative ones with Alt. Some negative. Negative. Then we go with the smoothing brush. Smoothing brush. That is shift. No matter what brush you have on, with if you press shift, it's gonna start smoothing the project. Now control shift, I want to isolate the head so I can be focusing on the head. I'm gonna start like this one is supposed to be just, let me try to fix that. I'm gonna try to do it with either trim it, put it in an intensity of low intensity. There you go. Now I'm going to do inflate. F. Now I'm going to use a standard brush with an alpha. That alpha is going to be alpha 25. And I'm going to do it with the drag rectangle. Control C. I believe it's another one. Let's see. Either this one, nope. This one over here. I believe that works. Remember, it's your island. You can do whatever you want with yours. So, there you go. Now for the top, we're going to do the clay tips, intensity 28. And then we're going to do a snake hook focal shift. I'm going to turn it a little bit smaller to make the points. Before that, I'm going to inflate this so I can grab them easier. Inflate. 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 Now it has like a little bit of volume to the area. Now we snake hook with a focal shift of 84. Gonna make kind of points for to make it look more mean, you know, like super bad. Or I can turn X out. Control C, Control C. F. We can move around those ones too. Move. Remember, I didn't have X, so I'm gonna fix this one over here. There you go. Now we put X again. There you go. Looks good. And remember, I'm doing this. I don't want to be like 4 hours here. So I'm giving you the basics. So you guys, Control C, because I have this alpha, I'm going to turn it off. I'm going to make dots, standard. There you go, the standard brush, Control C, it's too big. And the intensity, probably 10. But yeah, you guys, let me do a more intensity, 38 probably. Probably 24. Yeah, there you go. 24 works great. Draw size, maybe 11 now. some negatives too, to make some kind of marks that this has over here. It's like leaf marks. And then again, let me tell you, if you have a background in drawing, you're gonna have a less hard time with this program. It's way better if you have already some kind of artistic background, sculpting too. Bigger brush for this over here. For these are like three kind of if you see these ones are like triangles down with something. So for those ones, we're gonna do something exciting. I'm gonna tell you in a little bit how to do it. And actually, let's try to do it right now. Brush, insert. We can try to do it with one from here, but I don't think they have it. So let's save this project. Control Shift, save, save, yes. Now we are going to choose cylinder, right click, cube 3D, there you go, F, make polymesh, polyframe, we don't need it like that, so I'm going to do it dynamesh, I don't need it to be that refined, so 64, dynamesh, there you go, W, and I'm going to make it small. Maybe like that, and this one like this. Maybe this one a little bit. All this I'm doing it with W, the W key, and polyframe off. I'm gonna set up my music now. I'm still listening. Yes. Okay. Q, X. X, we're gonna make this the pivot. This is X, so if that's X, let's see, transform, symmetry, Y, nope, symmetry, C, there you go, it's in Z. Okay, so for this, what I'm gonna be doing pretty much is gonna be something simple. I'm gonna control mask rectangle, there you go, inverse, and I'm gonna rotate it, rotate Control A, there you go. Control A, Q. I'm gonna, with move, I'm gonna move this around, sculpt this in the way I want it to be. Smooth it out, smooth that out, smooth that out. Now if we go, you'll see that it has kind of the hair has this kind of stuff over here, like this, some stuff, maybe like this. There you go. And the way we want it to be, Then we put it like that. Now we're gonna, for this, we're gonna press brush, create insert mesh. Yes, new. Okay, now we go back, subtool. We're gonna go back to, we're gonna go back and choose the one that we had before. It was PM3D. There you go. And now that we have it over here, you'll see that we have this selected, so we can go and we're gonna grab it. We don't wanna do it like that. Control C, now we're gonna go. We're gonna go on struck curve, curve mode. Step one, yeah. Okay, we're gonna make this a little bit smaller. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so 1. If you want it to be bigger, so you make bigger your brush here when it's red and click it. No, a little bit more. Bigger and click it. A little bit more and click it. And then we're gonna go to the stroke curve step 0.1. Stroke step 0. Stroke as a line. Okay, so I can do it bigger over here, and then till I touch it and it becomes blue. Control C. I believe that looks way better, don't you think? Control C. Wow. I didn't notice, and Control C. This is making all the project very, very heavy. Right now we are at 5 million polygons. And all because of that. Okay, so let's clear this over here. Delete. There you go. We're gonna reduce that. Let's see if Dynamesh works on that. If it doesn't work, we're gonna go and decimate it. We're gonna have to go on Decimation Master. Yeah, it's down to 60. There you go. So now let's move this around till it looks kind of like what we see. Just kind of a texture with the inflate. There's a hole over here. We clay tubes. We're gonna make Alt. Smooth it out. going to put a little bit of texture in the feet. First, we're going to make the pointy fingers with the pinch tool. There you go. There you go. One, two, two more to go. There you go. Now we are going to stand our brush with the drag rectangle and the alpha that we did before, but it's this one over here. Let's make it weird. Alien. F. Okay, we save. Yes. Let's make it here too, you know? Let's make it look good. Okay, so now what I was gonna do, oh yeah, the tail. For this we are gonna do the same. So we're gonna go and press the Q3D, F, make polymesh. Okay, there you go. Now we're gonna make the dorsal spine. So for this we're gonna polyframe. Okay, we're gonna geometry, dynamesh. We're gonna make 32 instead of 64. I believe it was too heavy last time. Polyframe, there you go. Now W, let's make it small. Small, let's make it small and small. There you go. Now this one, the same. All this is with W. F, F, Q, X. Okay, X is in the other side, so we're gonna rotate it. Let's see if this works. There you go, there you go. Q, pivot, there you go. Now we're gonna go snake hook, make it big, the focal shift. Now we want it more like 16. 1, 2, inflate. There you go. Now remember, this is an alien. Dynamesh is selected. Now we do it again. Let's do like a 456, okay? Control A. Control C. Dynamesh. There you go. Okay, now I'm gonna use snake hook. Focal shift, small. I want it to look like a. Control C. Now pinch. Let's pinch this. There you go. Now clay tubes. Just give like a little bit of personality to this. There you go. F. So we're gonna put it the way we want it. So I'm gonna put it facing this way. Then a mesh off, and now we're gonna go down, and resolution probably. I'm gonna use zero measure, and we're gonna use half the size, zero mesh. There you go. And now we're gonna brush, create insert mesh, new. Yes, now we go back to the alien that we had over there. Hello. F. Control shift. Okay, so now, same as that one over there. X. X. There you go. We have X on. And we can be one by one, but Control C. We're going to do it with the tool curve. Curve mode. Yeah. Excellent. If you want it to be bigger, a bigger brush, and then we make it blue. Control C. We drag it around. Smaller, small brush. We drag it around. If you want to continue the line, Control C. So you know how this works now, right? Control C. So as long as you have this line under, you can be making it bigger or smaller. And you can continue the line. If you see this one, you can go a little bit more steps. Control C. Well, it's supposed to. So let's make it a little bit bigger. Then move it. There you go. Okay, there you go, two masks, and it's going to project it. Okay, Control Shift. Now we have to refine this because it doesn't really look like a tail, so now play tubes, intensity 28, we have to make it look organic, Control C, see what happened over here, I just touched something that I didn't want to touch. We're going fast. I'm trying to do this tutorial as fast as I can, but let's try to do it clean. I just don't want this to look too plain. We can add texture. I'm doing this fast, so now I'm gonna use the snake hook, make it bigger. Now smaller. There you go. Menacing. There you go. Control shift. Now we drag a mask to make the dynamesh remesh all this over here. Projection in progress. There you go. Remember to save, yes. I'm gonna make now a little bit of a smoothing, smooth. And now I can do another snake hook, make a few ones. Freaking alien, for Christ's sake. Control C, I didn't like the very last one. There you go, with that is okay, you know. Now, the last thing, but not less, the fangs. Right now. Well, we need to do the backside too, with snake hook, we can do it too. Control C, let's make it bigger. Focal shift like 8. One, two. There you go. We can do it here too, with the shoulders. F. There you go. Now let's make the fangs to close this. We got a sweep tool, a pant. We're gonna paint a sphere 3D, select it, transparency. We size it down, size it down, size it down, down, down. I believe that's good. W, we move it around all the way to the front. Put it there. Now the same again. We're gonna drag it around. The size again is smaller. There you go. There you go. Okay, now Q. We're gonna make either a snake hook. Yeah, snake hook. There you go. We can use a pinch. There you go. Now we duplicate. W, put it down. Rotate it. Rotate it. Rotate it. W. Move it around. Move it around. We merge those ones down. Always okay, skip this. We go to plugin, soft tool master, mirror. Yes, there you go. Now we're gonna do another one. Append. We're gonna append a sphere. Select the sphere, size it down. This is a different approach I did for the other one, something different, but I believe this is gonna work. F, F, W, put it all the way to the front. W, okay, now snake hook again. Control C. It was something weird because it was not in selected in the mode that we wanted it. Pinch. There you go. Move. Duplicate. W. Duplicate. Duplicate. This one is too way to the back, so now I'm gonna put it to the front. This one the same. There you go. Now we're gonna merge those ones. Merge down. One, two, three. same C plugin, so tool master, mirror. Okay, there you go. Now we're gonna duplicate that one, select it, and so tool master. If that's X, this should be Y, right? Plugin, so tool master, mirror. There you go. Okay. So, Control C. Didn't work that way. So W, because Control C. Rotation. There you go. W. Rotation, control, rotate, W, move, control C, X, I didn't have a symmetry on. F, you can scale it down if you want. E, there you go. W, Control C, X. F, transparency off, Q, there you go. The rest will be like painting it. You could be painting this, choose the material you want. Let's see which one looks a little bit more realistic. Sketch toy plastic, and we go here and we choose the standard colorize, C add off, RGB, alpha off, spray, and we choose the gray we want it. Kind of like a dark one. Paint it all first. It was kind of like different colors over here. It's kind of like a yellowish, don't you think? How did you see? It was kind of like that one. Kind of like that one. For this part over here, and then kind of like this one with intensity like 11, then a dark one in the part, the back part. Let's see how. There you go. And then again, we chose it with C. Choose that color, then C again. on this part again. It's kind of black. And this part, let's see, is kind of like that. Then see on the tail, it's kind of black. I guess this one is going to be like that. See, I guess the hands are going to be like that, the feet. F. Remember, you can spend as much time as you want refining. You can be using like this brush spray with an alpha, with alpha to make it look like more like real. Like you can use this color, the black one. See, and then intensity like a 4%. Then we go C. Then we do the same. You can go draw a size, a small one. F. And then you can go to the, let's merge these ones down, that one. This one too, let's merge it over there. And for those ones, let's make a white, or a, yeah, it's a white. But not that white, let's make it a little bit more dark. There you go. It was too white. Remember, you can be like painting forever this. Intensity 100. Same. Make some interesting things, you know, to make it look more. Interesting. Well, I hope that you liked this tutorial. It was a pretty fun one for me. You can render your aliens, and you can choose different materials. Different sizes, perspectives, pretty much. You can make a turntable too. And let me know what you think about it, about the tutorial. The hands were black, right? Yeah, I believe we're gonna do it black. They don't come out that well, you know. Okay, let's do it just for sake of the model. So let's make this seam, and then the hands black seam. I don't think they look that good. Let's take it back. See, they look better like that. You can see them, right? See, F. There you go. Well, guys, I hope you had fun. Any questions, any comments, please let me know. Thank you for watching this tutorial. This was the Aliens Ghost Baby Predator style. And let me know what you think. Make yours. And I hope you send me some awesome, like Ghost Baby Aliens. Have fun. Thank you. Rate, subscribe, and please like.